Hello everyone, so welcome to our PC414 Geotechnical Engineering 1. Our topic for this day will be your soil bearing capacity. So what is soil bearing capacity? It is the capacity of the soil to support the loads applied to the ground. So we're going to talk about the contact pressure between our soil and the foundation. So it is the maximum average of contact pressure between the foundation and the soil, which should not be produce shear failure in soil. So we have lots of, or marami tayong types or different types of foundation. Diba, we have deep footing, square footing. No, but for now, or for this topic, we will try to focus on shallow foundation. So this bearing capacity is based on Terzaghi's theory, no, which is si Carl von Terzaghi was the first present or comprehensive theory for the evaluation of the ultimate bearing capacity of rough shallow foundations. So we know that Carl Terzaghi is the father of soil mechanics. No, this is based on our topic during the prelims. So this theory, which is for the soil bearing capacity, states that a foundation is shallow if its depth is less than or equal to its width. Later investigation, however, have suggested that foundations with a depth measured from the ground surface equals to 3 to 4 times their width may be defined as shallow foundations. So that is why for this topic now we will try to focus on shallow foundations only. So the equations which take into account your soil cohesion, your soil friction, the embankment, and the surcharge, and the self-weight. So according to the Terzaghi's bearing capacity, no, so we have lots of formulas to be considered for our general shear failure. Okay, but dito, no, mas madali na i-memorize lang natin yung sa rectangular natin na footing, no? So you have here your cohesion depth and dimension for our circular footing. So you have 1.3 CNC plus QNQ plus 0.3 gamma B and gamma. So for your square footing, you have 1.3 CNC plus QNQ plus 0.4 gamma B and gamma. For your strip footing, you have CNC plus QNQ plus 0.5 gamma B and gamma. And for your rectangular footing, no, yung mas mahaba, that is your CNC quantity 1 plus 0.3 B over L quantity plus QNQ plus 0.5 B and gamma times 1 minus 0.2 B over L. Dami, no? So itong CNC natin, no, yung CNC plus 1 plus 0.3 B over L, this is your strength due to cohesion. Okay, and itong QNQ natin, this is your overburden pressure, or I mean, that is your strength due to surcharge, which is in result for your overburden pressure. So ito namang 0.5 gamma B and gamma, 1 minus 0.2 B over L, that is your strength due to footing dimensions. So that is where you have three properties now for your bearing capacity equation: the cohesion, the surcharge, and the dimension. So as you can see, no, itong sa apat na formulas nito, you have NC, you have NQ, and you have your N gamma. So these are your bearing coefficient factors. So most of the problem, no, sa given problems, meron tong table na pwede ninyong hanapin yung value ng NC, NQ, N gamma. So swerte na yon. But for some, no, sa ibang problems or sa ibang problems din sa board exam, is hindi binibigay yung value ng NC, NQ, and N gamma. So we have formulas for this para ma-solve siya. But for this topic, na lang, no, siguro, I will give you the value of your NC, NQ, and gamma. So, para hindi na masyadong madagdagan pa yung formulas na inyong i-memorize. So, talking about the base and the length, no, ng ating footing or foundation, always remember lang that the smallest dimension is the base. No, para hindi kayo malito. Yan, no? Base is lesser than the length. So, local shear failure. So, this is for your circular footing where your cohesion is 2/3 of C. Now, yan yung primes na nakikita ninyo for the local shear failure. So, same lang naman pa rin, no, yung equation or yung formula. The only thing is C prime na yung kinoconsider natin, which is 2/3 of the original cohesion. So, Terzaghi's bearing capacity. So, dito lang sila nagkakaiba, no, ng formula. So, mas mahalaga pa rin talaga na memorize nyo yung rectangular footing. No, kasi most of the equations is nasa kanya. Okay, so for your factor of safety, that is your ultimate bearing capacity over your allowable bearing capacity. So, this is the table na sinasabi ko. No, so you have your internal angle of friction. So you have your NC, NQ, and gamma. So that is 0 to 50. So we have formulas for that, no, since sa sinabi ko kanina. So kukunin niyo lang yung value ng internal angle of friction. So sabihin natin 10 yung nakuha. So you have the value for your NC, for your NQ, and for your N gamma. But again, sabi ko sa inyo, for this topic, ibibigay ko na lang agad yung values ng NC, NQ, and gamma. So, kapag nagsistudy na lang kayo using the other reference, no, try to learn on how to get the NC, NQ, and gamma for your stock knowledge na lang din. Okay? So, this is for your local shear failure for your Terzaghi's bearing capacity. So, let us try to solve an example, no, for your soil bearing capacity. So, the figure shown is a rectangular footing, 1.2 meters by 1.2 meters. So, the unit weight of the soil is 17.3 kilonewton per cubic meter and has a cohesion of 9.6 kilopascal. The angle of internal failure is 28 degrees, assume no water table exists below the foundation and assuming that the general shear failure in soil. So, the bottom of the footing is 0.9 meters from the ground surface. So, determine the ultimate bearing capacity, the allowable bearing capacity using the factor of safety of 2.5 and the gross allowable load for the footing that can carry. So, itong ating footing or the bottom of our footing is 0.9 meters below the soil surface. So, yung Q natin or yung surcharge natin, that is in a formula of, yung Q natin dito, no, that is gamma H. Sorry, nadala ko yung sa, ano natin, sa lateral earth pressure. So, yung internal angle of friction is 28, given na yung NC, NQ, and gamma natin is this value. Okay, this is for your general shear failure. So, hanapin natin yung ultimate bearing capacity. So, since this is square footing, we will use the formula 1.3 CNC QNQ plus 0.4 gamma BN gamma. So, 1.3 times 9.6, this is the cohesion, times our NC, which is given. Plus your Q, yung Q natin is gamma H. So, this is 17.3. times 0.9 times your NQ. Okay? Plus 0.4 times 17.3 times yung base natin na 1.2 times your N gamma given kanina na show ko, that is 13.70. And your ultimate bearing capacity is equivalent to 785.559 kilopascal. Next question is for the allowable bearing capacity. So, we will use the formula for your factor of safety. Given that your factor of safety is equivalent to 2.5. O, baka narito kayo, dinerive lang yung equation. Pero, pwede naman to gawin na mag-shift solve na lang kayo. No? So, this is 2.5 yung Q ultimate natin is 785.559. So, shift solve na lang kung nalilito kayo sa pag-derive ng formula. And that is equivalent to 314.224 kilopascal. So, same unit pa rin since your factor of safety is unit less. Okay, letter C is the gross allowable load, which is yung ating induced load for your footing. So, we know that your force, no, is, I mean, yung pressure natin is force over the area. So, allowable natin is equals to P also. So, F is equals to Q times A. So, that is 314.224 times the area of our footing, which is 1.2 by 1.2. And that is equivalent to 452.483 kilonewton. Very easy. Anong kalaban nyo dito? Formula lang. Okay? So, let us talk about the modification of your bearing capacity. No, that is due to the presence of water na. So, ibig sabihin, meron na tayong kinoconsider na water table sa ating soil. So, we have, I think, 4 cases or 5 cases for your modification for bearing capacity. First is that you have your case 1. Okay, so you have the depth of your footing. Ito. Depth of your footing from the soil surface papunta sa ating bottom of the footing. So, your groundwater table, ito, the distance is, sabihin natin, D1 from the soil surface papunta sa water table. So, from the water table papunta sa bottom of our footing, tawagin natin tong D2. Okay, makaka-affect ang water table natin or the value of your water table sa pagkuha natin ng ultimate bearing capacity. No, since ang soil natin is magre-react doon sa ina-apply natin sa kanya. So, first case is that if D1 or yung distance na ating water table from the soil surface is lesser than the depth of your footing from the soil surface to the bottom of the footing, your Q is equivalent to gamma D1 plus gamma prime dito. Saan ba yung Q natin? Kung naalala ninyo, that is CNC plus, ano nga yun? CNC plus, di ko lang muna isulat yung ibang coefficients ha, para makita nyo lang. Q and Q. Itong Q daw natin dito ngayon will be gamma D1 plus gamma prime D2. So, gamma prime, ibig sabihin, saturated naman to, di ba? No? So, yung saturated natin ngayon, yun yung imumultiply natin sa distance 2. So, in plus naman natin to ng gamma B and gamma. Yung gamma B daw natin dito or yung gamma natin dito is equivalent to gamma. Ibig sabihin, gamma prime is equals to gamma sat minus the gamma water. No, tanggalin natin yung tubig or yung unit weight of water. Parang parehas pa rin sa topic natin during the prelims, no, yung pore water pressure. Parang ganun yung idea niya. Naaalisin natin yung tubig. So, case 2 is that yung distance ng footing natin is also equals to the distance of your water table from the soil surface. So, meaning to say, yung water table natin is nasa ilalim mismo ng ating footing. So, if D1 is equals to D2, your Q value is gamma D1. Where in our gamma B and gamma, your gamma is equals to gamma prime, and that is gamma sat minus gamma water. So, ano yung pinagkaiba natin dito sa case 1 and case 2? Yung Q lang, di ba? Yung binago. Yung Q lang yung nagbago. So, yun yung first two cases natin. Next is case 3. So, case 3 natin, mas bumaba pa yung ating water table. So, again, DF pa rin is the distance from the soil surface papunta sa bottom of the footing. Yung D natin is the distance from the bottom of the footing papunta sa ating water table. Okay? So, if D is less than B, therefore, your Q is equivalent to gamma DF. Gamma, unit weight, times D, the distance of the bottom of the footing papunta sa soil surface. Your gamma B and gamma is equivalent to gamma D plus gamma prime B minus D. Where yung B natin dito, gamma B ha, gamma B. Where yung B natin dito is the base of the footing. Okay, and again, your gamma sat is the difference between the gamma saturated minus gamma of water. Case 4. Okay, case 4 na natin to. So, case 4 natin is that if the depth of the footing, I mean, if the depth of the water table is greater than the value of our base, no? Ito, mas greater sa base natin or sa B distance natin. So, Q is equals to DF pa din. But for your gamma B and gamma, gamma B is just equals to gamma B. Ibig sabihin, sobrang layo ng water table sa bottom ng ating footing. So, clarify ko lang dito, ito yung base. Tapos, if yung water table natin is pasok pa rin siya sa distance ng value ng base natin, no? Yan yung case 3. But if the location of the water table from the bottom of our footing is greater than the value of our base, therefore, parang natin siyang i-consider as dry na. Kasi as you can see, no, yung gamma natin dito or yung unit weight natin dito is hindi na natin siya minainasan ng gamma of water. No? Kasi parang tinignit na natin yung soil natin dito as dry. So let us try this example. No? So you have a square footing and has a dimension of 1.3 by 1.3. So, you have a bottom of 0.9 below the ground surface. Assume a general shear failure. Determine the ultimate bearing capacity of the soil if the groundwater table is located at 0.6 meters below the ground surface. So, ano na lang yan? Conditions B, C, and D. So, you have the unit weight of 17.6. So, you have cohesion of 12.2. Internal angle of friction as 30 and gamma saturated as 19.7. So, given na yung ating NC, NQN, and gamma. So, pwede ko pa rin naman pala kayo, no, bigyan ng table. So, ang mahalaga lang dito is yung value ng angle of internal friction. Okay, so this is our figure. So, the bottom of our footing is located 0.9 meters from the soil surface. And water table can be seen 0.6 meters from the soil surface. So, that is your D sub 2. So, para makuha natin yung, D sub 1. So, para makuha natin yung D sub 2, since the total height is 0.9, i-minus lang natin yung 0.6. No, that is equivalent to 0.3. So, base of our square footing is 1.3. So, this is the formula natin for our square footing. So, in-address ko na lang agad yung equation. No, since this is pasok tayo sa case 1. So, yung Q natin ngayon will be gamma D1 plus gamma prime D2 NQ. So, yung gamma B and gamma natin, so that is 0.4. As you can see, that is gamma prime B and gamma. No, since D1 is less than our DF. So, pasok tayo sa case 1. Okay, read with me. So, you have 1.3 times the value of our cohesion times the value of our NC plus 17.6. Sulat ko na lang. This is your 17.6 and yung saturated natin na unit weight is 19.7. So, sige. So, that is 7.6 times 0.6. Ito yon. Plus, itong gamma prime natin, di ba? Gamma prime natin is equivalent to gamma sat minus gamma of water. Or unit weight of water minus unit weight. A unit weight of the saturated minus unit weight of water. So, that is 19.7 minus 9.81 times 0.3, which is the D2, times our NQ. Plus 0.4 times yung ating gamma prime, that is gamma sat minus gamma of water, times our base 1.3 times the value of your n gamma. So total, that is 991.556 kilopascal. Next question is that if our water table is located at the bottom of our footing, so kunin natin yung ultimate bearing capacity. So that is 1.3 CNC plus yung Q natin ngayon. Tingnan nyo, yung Q natin ngayon is equivalent to gamma D1 since DF or yung depth of the bottom of your footing from the soil surface is equals to D1. So 0.4 gamma prime BN gamma. So substitute natin yung values. So you have yung walang yung unbothered lang talaga dito, you know, is yung cohesion. Kahit anong case, hindi siya nagbabago. The unbothered cohesion. Okay. So you have here for your yung strength due to yung strength due to surcharge, no? So you have here 17.6 times 0.9. Okay, 17.6 na to. Times 0.9 times 22.46. Take note ha, dry na to yung binoconsider natin since yung water table natin is nandito. Okay, hindi 19.7 yung i-consider. Alright. So, plus 0.4 since our gamma prime again is gamma sat minus gamma water. 1.3 times 19.13. Very easy lang. Therefore, the answer is 1043.506 kilopascal. Next is, how about our water table is located 1.2 meters. 1.2 meters from the ground. So, ibig sabihin, lagpas na siya sa ating DF or sa depth of your footing from the soil surface. Pero, pasok pa rin siya sa distance, no, ng ating base, which is 1.3 meters. So, B minus D, so that is 1.3 minus 0.3, that is equivalent to 1 meter. So, the distance of our water table galing sa bottom of our footing, ito, that is 0.3. No? Sana na you are with me pa. So, since case, ano na to? No? If D is lesser than B. So, as you can see, ang nagbago dito, unbothered pa rin si cohesion. Ang ating Q is equivalent to QD1. Okay, so yung ating gamma B, that is 0.4 times gamma D plus gamma prime B minus Dn gamma. So, gamma B na to. No? Kung naalala nyo doon sa previous natin na sinow ko kanina. So, the unbothered 1.3 CNC. So, next is 17.6 times 0.9. No? D1 is equals to DF na tayo dito times 22.46. Plus 0.4, your gamma, 17.6 ito, dito tayo yung pinag-uusapan natin, 17.6 times 0.3, plus 19.7 minus 9.81, ito yon gamma sat minus gamma water, times 1 na tayo dito, B minus D, ito B minus D. So this is 1.3 minus 0.3, that is equivalent to 1, times your n gamma. Therefore, your soil bearing capacity is equivalent to 1061.205 kilopascal. And lastly, if your groundwater table is located 2.3 meters from the soil surface. So, as you can see, no, this is equivalent to 2.3. So, 2.3, tapos lagpas na tayo sa ating height of your base, which is 1.3. Okay? So, lagpas na tayo, ibig sabihin, yung water table natin is considered as sobrang layo na sa bottom of our footing. Okay? So, meaning to say, i-consider, parang kino-consider na natin that yung soil below our footing, which is 1.3 meters below, no, is dry natin siya i-consider. So therefore, we will have the value of 1.3 CNC. Yung Q ninyo is gamma D1 and your gamma B is just equivalent to gamma B lang pa rin. So you have your 1.3 CNC for your cohesion. So this is 17.6 times 0.9. Dito nang galing yung 0.9 times your N gamma plus 0.4 times 17.6. O baka nagtataka kayo bakit hindi 19.7 yung ginamit. No? Again, wala na tayong water table dito. So kino-consider natin to as dry na lang. So that is 17.6 times B natin, which is 1.3 times your N gamma. And that is equivalent to 1,120.202 kilopascal. And that ends our solvering capacity topic. So if you have any questions, clarifications, no, for this problem, no, you know where to find me. So thank you everyone and God bless.